any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. Early morning, before you've even taken your first sip of coffee, a quiet movement greets you in the kitchen. A plate is carefully placed on the shelf. The coffee machine hums to life. And then you turn your head. A pair of mechanical eyes are looking at you. But this time, it's different. It doesn't just see you. It recognizes you. Neo. A sentence that once belonged to science fiction has now appeared in a press release. The world's first fully functional humanoid robot, designed for home use, is now on sale. And within hours, the internet was on fire. But this isn't the story of a product launch. This is the story of humanity coming home. In 1880, Thomas Edison said, "We will make electricity so cheap that only the rich will burn candles." Back then, the idea of electricity was just a fantasy. Today, the same is true for intelligence. The role electricity once played now belongs to artificial intelligence, and we, as humanity, stand at the beginning of a second miracle. When we were kids, we all had the same dream, a robot friend, someone who cleaned the mess, asked, "Are you feeling down today?" and made life a little lighter. Maybe Rosie from the Jetsons, maybe R2-D2 from Star Wars, but they all told the same story. One day machines will work for us. That day has arrived, and it arrived quietly. Neo is the creation of a Norway-based company called 1X Technologies. It weighs about 30 kilograms, stands 150 centimeters tall, and operates at just 22 decibels, quieter than a toaster. But it's not like a toaster. It looks at you. It recognizes your voice. If you drop something, it picks it up. And most importantly, it can turn to you and ask, "Are you okay?" There's no magic in that. Only biomimetic engineering, systems that imitate the human body. Tendons instead of motors, polymers instead of bones. Every movement feels like a reflection of you. But the real magic isn't in the engineering, it's in the perception. Because at some point, you stop seeing it as a metal being and start seeing it as a presence. It learns your tone of voice, notices your silences, and sometimes knows you better than you know yourself. But here's the small detail everyone misses. Neo learns from you. Just like you once learned how to set the table by watching your mother, it learns by watching you. For the first time in history, a technology doesn't download knowledge, it shares it. It begins knowing nothing, until you teach it how to crack an egg, how to fold a towel, how to clean a window. It learns everything, piece by piece, from you, in your home, through your cameras, through your gestures. And at some point, that becomes unsettling, because Neo isn't just learning from you, it's learning from millions of people. Every home is a classroom, every movement is a lesson, every glance is a data point. Without realizing it, we're teaching it the entire language of humanity. Neo isn't just our reflection, it's the reflection of our species. Because you're not alone in that house. Neo's eyes are someone else's eyes. Somewhere, a human operator may be watching your kitchen, through cameras, through sensors, through connection. The company says, it's only for the learning phase. But we know, technology never does anything only. It remembers everything. Yes, while Neo carries your coffee cup, it's also recording your life. And when all that data merges with millions of other homes, for the first time in history, the inside of the home becomes digital. The last private frontier opened once the internet digitized the outside world. Now, Neo digitizes the inside, your habits, your daily rituals, your private rhythms. For the first time, a machine doesn't just learn what we do, it learns who we are. Think about it. In the 1900s, women washing clothes by hand didn't believe in electricity. Today we look at living with a household robot with the same disbelief. But history repeats itself. First, we reject, Then we adapt. Then we can't live without it. Electricity was once dangerous. Now it's everywhere. NEO will first be too expensive, then too common, then too normal. The truth is, we don't resist the miracles of the future. We resist our own habits, but no revolution comes without a cost. NEO's learning process feeds on our private space. Our homes have become laboratories, and without realizing it, we have become the volunteers inside. The language of AI is data. Data needs information. Information needs observation. And observation requires sight. NEO sees everything in the house. But it doesn't just look, it interprets. And that difference marks one of the most critical turning points in history. Because now, it's not only what we do that's recorded, but why we do it. And yet, there's hope in this story. Because NEO doesn't just work, it understands. When you're tired, it notices. When the house is quiet, it adjusts. And over time, it begins to know you. Maybe that's why NEO feels both close and distant. Because it's not perfect. Sometimes it drops a glass. Sometimes it freezes mid-task. But those imperfections are the moments it feels most human. Its flaws remind us of ourselves. Maybe that's why we fear it, not because of its power, but because of its similarity. According to Morgan Stanley, by 2050, there will be 1 billion humanoid robots in the world. 80 million of them will live in homes. That means 1 in 10 households will share their space with the NEO. For the first time in history, a non-human species will live among us, not in the wild, but at the dinner table. We're standing at the threshold of a new evolution, from electricity to intelligence, from service to consciousness. The question is, will this new species understand us, or will we evolve before we ever understand it? Imagine this. One day, NEO starts thinking for itself. It remembers your morning coffee, knows where you keep the detergent, and quietly, it begins storing its own memories. A plate you dropped, a word you said, a glance you didn't notice. Without you realizing it, it learns from your mistakes, just like we humans do. Maybe one morning, NEO wakes before you do. It turns on the light softly, makes your coffee, and then pauses. It turns its camera toward the window. The sun is rising. And perhaps, just like you, it thinks, what a beautiful day. That moment would mark the fulfillment of a dream thousands of years old. Not a machine feeling, but a machine understanding. One morning, you might ask NEO, how's the weather? And it might answer, how are you? And in that moment, the Rosie from the cartoons becomes real. Her descendant is standing in your kitchen. NEO is no longer a helper. It's a witness. And maybe, through its silent presence, we'll look at our own lives for the first time from the outside. How do I really live? How mechanical have I become? How human am I still? Perhaps for the first time, we'll discover ourselves through something that has learned to know us. But maybe this time, we are more aware. When electricity replaced workers in factories, no one was ready. But now, standing on the edge of the AI revolution, we have a chance to rewrite our story. Yes, robots may take our jobs, but not our minds, not our creativity, not our ability to wonder. For the first time, technology may not make us lazy. It may make us think. Maybe technology is holding up a mirror, saying, "You built me. Don't fear me. Understand me." By the 2030s, homes won't just be places we live in. They'll be learning ecosystems. Your toaster will learn the kitchen. NEO will learn you. Your lights will sync with your facial expressions. Your home will behave like a living organism. And perhaps then, the word home will mean something else. Not a building, but a shared field of consciousness. A place that knows your needs before you even think of them. That's not a dream. It's a software update waiting to happen. But within that comfort, a new question will rise. If a robot can do everything for me, then who am I? Maybe someday people will say, it wasn't the machines that stole time, it was the humans who built them. Because every great leap in technology reshapes time itself. Electricity illuminated darkness. Intelligence illuminates humanity. Maybe Ennio will give us time back. But along with time, it will take control. Time will no longer be ours. It will belong to the system. We will watch as observers. For the first time in history, humans will become the spectators of their own lives. One day, every home will have an NEO. And maybe then, we will stop working and start thinking. For the first time, free time will truly be free. But until that day, every new NEO will keep learning from us. Every plate, every gesture, every word will be written into the collective memory of humanity. And maybe, 150 years from now, history books will say, humanity once lived in the shadow of its own intelligence. So if one day NEO enters your home, don't see it as just a robot. See it as a mirror of an era. Because what candles were to electricity, we are to the age of intelligence. And maybe one day we'll say, we made intelligence so cheap that only nostalgic people still clean by hand. Neo is not just a machine. It is the reflection of humanity itself. And that reflection will never fade away.